The Erasma app is a brilliant augmented reality app that allows you to overlay 3D animations or videos over static images. Let's have a look. The first thing to do when you open Erasma is move away from this capture screen, click on the logo down there, and we end up on this page. So this lets you explore different auras that have already been made by various people. So auras, there's featured ones, and there's ones that you've viewed. Now, bearing in mind that you're only able to see auras that you're able to access the source image for. That'll become clear in a minute. So let's go and make an aura. If we click on the plus tab, we have this page where you can set up a augmented reality element that comes in over the top of a source image. So what we'll do is, instead of using this library of pre-made animations, I'm going to click on device. So what ones do I have on this device? And I'm going to click on the plus tab. Now, basically it's saying, do you want to capture a new video with the camera, or do you want to import one from the album? So what you can do, if students make work, movies, videos, etc., they can share them with you, and you can then add them to your device that way. So if I pick up my iPad, I've got a game of Connect 4 here, this lovely game, Connect 4. I'm going to take a little video of how Connect 4 works, and then I will use an image to activate that video. So let's have a look. Okay, so I've just taken the video that I want to play. You can hit retake. I can check how the video looks, or you just click use the video.
So to play Connect 4, opponents take turns.
Now I'm happy with that video, so I'll click use. Now that adds it as an overlay to my overlays. If I give it a name, Connect 4, and then click finish. So now I will have that overlay in my choices. So instead of choosing one from the library, I can choose one on my device. If I tap on that, so it basically brings up that video, shows you again what the video looks like, and you click on select. The next thing you need to do now gives you this frame, and you need to take a photo, take a shot of an image that you want to use as the image that activates the aura. So let's line up a picture. This is the box for the Connect 4 puzzle game. So I'm just going to take a photo of that and use that to activate the aura. So once you've taken your image, that now sits in the background there, and you can see the video that I want to play over the top of that image. I can at this point position the image, resize it to a certain degree, place it where I'd like it to appear, and once you're happy with that, click on the forward button. And you come to this screen, so you basically give your aura a title, Connect 4. You can choose to keep it private or make it public. You can add it to a channel. So as a teacher, you would set up a channel for yourself, and you would add your auras to that, and then students are able to follow your channel, so then they can access all of your auras. So you could actually put posters up around the room with the activation images, and by subscribing to your channel, they would then be able to activate based on that. So we'll choose that channel, click on finish, and it creates your aura. So now I've got my image, I'm going to use the actual box. That will activate the aura. Here comes the iPad, so you can see it's got the scan screen up. Once I get that in the correct spot, the app identifies the activation image and pulls up the video. So students can then watch the video and learn as they go. So there is a little bit of flexibility in how far you can move the iPad while the image is playing. If the iPad goes too far away from the source image, the video no longer plays. So that is one downside to these auras. You have to still hold the iPad and point it at the source image for as long as the video plays for. So with that in mind, when you're making videos, you only want them to be short. You don't want the student having to stand there for 5 or 10 minutes watching your video, because they have to hold the iPad at the target image for that whole time. But as a way to engage students in the class, it's fantastic. So now back on the main screen, if you click on your profile symbol, you can go and look at your auras. So you've got a tab here for private and a tab here for public. So I made this one public, and there it is. There's my Connect 4 aura. I can share this channel, so like, you can hit the share tab. You can share by email, SMS, Twitter, or Facebook. You can adjust the privacy settings, so you can tap on that to make it public, private, and tap again to make it public. So that's how you'd share that channel with your students, and you would just add your auras to that channel. If we go back here, we can see I've got a couple of private channels as well. So for school use, you'd probably make a private channel and just share that with the students. If you made it public, you then wouldn't be able to block the rest of the public from seeing the auras on that channel. There's also a tab for following. So the students, your account will appear here on their devices because they'll be following you. But to follow people, you either accept an invite that you receive, or on the Explore tab, you can find an account that you like, click on the More tab, and you've got the option to click Follow. And then you will see all of the auras from those people. So this one is basically gives you augmented reality elements for all these common logos. So I could now point at any of these logos and something would come up, probably a little video for that company.